I'm Daniele Olivieri from Tarifa, Spain, and we are in KTS Tarifa, the shop and the school I run. So the goal today is as Wingfoil is becoming more and more popular nowadays, is to share my experience in order of choosing the right equipment according to the progression of each independent winger, and of course in order of decide to choose the right equipment in the future for our students. So I've got a couple of years of experience now in order of teaching wingfoiling too, together with kitesurfing, and it became also a passion, and it's really like another discipline, another possibility for us as a professional in the water sport to offer a new service. So what I would like to start is divided the presentation into what's possibility into the different type of wings, different type of boards, and different type of course of hydrofoil according to the progression and the experience. We start talking about the wing. So this is an F1 wing model. It's swing V2. It's a swing made it more for the progression and the free riding. So particularly things about the wing, general wing, is mainly different, as you probably know and see in the market, is having the handle or having a boom. Okay, so that's the main two differences between the different types of wings in the market. Of course, there are slightly different in terms of shape and aspect ratio also of the wing model. It's an inflatable structure and has different sizes, of course, doesn't need to say. So particularly of handle and F1 wing is the weight. Weight is very, very limited. This give you a lot of stability, performance, especially into the surfing moment, right? So the wing is really fly alone with the minimum wing. So in terms of handle, we have neutral handle, and we have holding handle, I call also like a mast handle, because they as a solid like a solid handle for you to hold the wing, and then the directional and powerful handle behind you. So this handle has been shaped a little bit more wider in order for you to move your hand depending on the direction you want to hold, and of course in terms depending on the wind it's gonna blow. To easier depowering. What else? The segments are shaped in different structures to make the wing very solid. Particularly important thing is really pump it up hard, because all the pressure is made by the center struts, and if the wing is not very well inflated, it could bend and lose performances. Leash could be wrist leash, which is made it for, made it connected pretty loose, I mean enough tight to doesn't release it and lose it, but pretty loose in order of for you to turn it around as you're gonna move in between your hands. And also the possibility is also to connect it either on your belt. There are some people using also like sort of belt to connect both leashes, either wing, and then we're gonna talk about later off the board. My recommendation is try to find out always good bright wings, as wing foiling is also made for long downwinds. It's good to have really like shiny and bright colors in order for you, for safety reason, to see you in deep water. And mainly that's it. That's a About the boards, here we have a large range of different type of boards in order of sizes and especially volume, rotability, capacity. So as beginner, we normally start with really big board. We're talking about actually inflatable, better, so software, less heating, less scratches, easier to handle and very light. So we got a 170 liter board that can be used as a normal stand-up paddle board, but also as a special beginner windsurf board. This particularly has three fins. We have also one special model that sometimes we also use for some really beginner and light wind condition with sideways fins, which give you much more stability and balance, especially of following the line into the cruising cross to the wind. Mandatory for the board is connect the leash into, again, either your ankle or either your waist belt. So we got 170, 140, and during the progression of our student, in the second or third lesson, depending on the experience of our student, we start to introduce the element, the possibility to connect the hydrofoil. So this inflatable board can be used either without or with hydrofoil mast. In order of the progression, we drop down to 130 liter board, so solid board, rigid board, fiberglass board, 130, and then dropping down we have 180, and for the most experienced and pro advanced, we got even 50 liter. In terms of first flying, I really highly recommend to use more like, okay, inflatable board for the really basic first step into hydrofoil, but then for a performance board, a solid rigid board, it might help you to feel the board sliding easier, and especially on the landing again in the water, a nicer thinner profile of the board, it might help you to easier dropping in the water. Of course, without strap to start, because strap is annoying for you to move around and to sit on first on knees and then standing up on board. And then for the one more advanced, want to start to make a few tricks, and especially for the jumping is a possibility of straps. Of course, won't forget once you go into the water, the element, safety element, flotability vest that help you for the flotation, but also for the impact, especially when you start foiling and the board start to flip around, the falling down could be prevented also by the impact vest, flotability vest, better to avoid injury on your ribs. And helmet mandatory as well, in order of course, as you know, with the board and with the blade afterwards in the water with the hydrofoil. In terms of hydrofoiling set, so there is a huge range of different hydrofoil, we call also planes, and different set of mast. What we recommend to start is with a short mast. We normally start 50, 65 in this case, up to 85 for the more advanced. So the mast, it give you, it doesn't allow you to go so high, so the falling down is not too heavy, so that's why we start with a shorter mast. But the most important thing is about the plane, the hydrofoil. So that's the biggest plane we have, which is measured in centimeters square, and it's 2200 centimeters square. This is at a slow speed, as you know, because of the shape and the size and the relation of the aspect ratio. It gives you an easier lifting. So for even on slow speed, it creates a lift and the board starts to fly. In the range, we've got 2200, 1800, down to 1500. These are considered low aspect ratio planes. So less longer, more wider, so easier to start and fly. And then for the most more advanced, we got the range of high aspect ratio wing, but it can go down 1280. and 1080. So this wing are a bit more technical to start, so to make it fly, so you need a bit of more speed, more technique to make it fly. But the plane is very long, so it's very prolongate. When you're flying, you have the capacity of surfing longer and faster. Of course, the speed, less friction, will be much more faster. So guys, this is basically all for all our gear. I hope this helped you to give you a better reference in terms of choosing the right equipment at the right stage. And go out there, enjoy kitesurfing at first, wingfoil in all water sport. All the best, see you soon.